Good evening and welcome back to Let's Play The Walking Dead Michonne. When we left off last time, we finished episode 2. Now episode 3 is finally available. What we deserve. Let's get in here. Pretty excited about this. Michonne is a really, really cool character, I think. For one, and this isn't actually related to her character, but I just really like the voice of the person who voices her. She's got a great voice. Beyond that, though, I mean, just what a cool character. She's tough. She's a survivor.
I've never killed anyone.
I'm not leaving you behind.
You start butchering their people, and our chances of making it out of here, any of us, go down to zero.
Oh, Pete, it was already too late. So when we left off, things are looking really, really bad back at the house.
They had some supplies just sitting out and...
Yeah, and you took them, you idiot.
I didn't think she was going to, but she let me go.
And then she stole from her again. That's why Norma's so pissed at her. She's totally justified, Norma is.
Michonne, what is it?
That was the worst right there. I really didn't... I should have expected that, but I didn't. So much pain for these poor kids. Losing everything. And then we killed this guy, because he sucks. And he's going to kill other people. He's a danger to everyone. And he was just saying some really just horrifying, nasty things at the end. Basically telling us that he was going to come back and kill all the children and kill everybody if we didn't kill him. Like, screw that guy. It's enough of you, Randall. Alright, but he does have a lot of pals out there in the woods, so... Did her girls actually die, or is this just a horrifying what-if? Is this just Michonne's mind messing with her? Where? It looks like we're back in the boat. A flashback! And now I need to know what's gonna happen now! Aw, everybody paling around. Michonne keeps to herself.
Hope you're not thinking about jumping. Because if you do, I'm gonna have to come in after you. Not looking forward to that. Water's gonna be an ice bath.
Really, you'd come after me?
You're one of us now.
Aww.
And I can't be the only brains around here.
I like his dog mug.
Freezing my ass off. Here. Coffee will warm you up.
What is that, Sharpay? Yeah, take a sip. Go for it. We can be pals.
God damn, Oak. You can't call it coffee when more than half's whiskey.
You sound like my ex-wife. She was more of a rum girl.
Hey, City! Did you hear the one about the kittens who took over the boat?
What?
Oh, no. Birdo, no.
He was a mutiny.
Birdo, just stop it now, okay? I'm warning you.
God damn.
I despised a lot of them when I first got on board, but they grow on you. Like mold, they are. Nah, sorry. That's shit, isn't it?
No, he's right.
They're growing on me, too.
It's a good place.
Nice that people can still joke around.
It's a fine line between the court jester and the village idiot. You can guess which side I think he's on.
They're a good team. Obviously, that's not going to last after all these escapades.
My brother and I were cooped up in an old canning factory. Food for ages. Lot of fat and happy people.
That sounds pretty good. What happened?
But then... a young girl got taken. We followed a trail. It wasn't hard with all the blood. Ended up cornering the people who took her.
Oh.
In this warehouse.
Not taken by zombies, taken.
All 10 of us went in. Only I came out.
Hmm. Well?
You did the right thing.
And it got my brother killed.
But you can't let people poach on your people.
Kiss my ass. A few weeks later, I came across Pete, ways up the coast. He saw that look on my face and he offered me a job. Didn't ask any questions, didn't turn me away, just welcomed me in.
That's good for Pete.
Pete's a good goddamn egg in a rotten world.
Yeah.
I don't always get Pete, but I'm glad people like him still exist.
I'll drink to that.
Now, Pete's a pretty cool guy.
Well,
maybe too trusting, but...
Berto's little routine is winding down, so we can finally play cards. Care to join us?
But the "I'll drink to that" is right. I mean, it is important that in such a bleak setting, you've got people that still will look out for the ones who are hurting, the ones who have lost people they care about, and will make a space for them. He still sees worth in them. So, yeah. Good on you, Pete.
It'd be nice to have you there. Besides, none of us can remember the rules. So...
What is it we're playing?
It'd be the most,
go
unique
fish.
Game of Go Fish you've ever played.
Yeah. Do me in.
You know, I don't know if I remember the rules to Go Fish either,
but... You might regret it when I win that machete of yours.
We're betting on Go Fish? Why don't we play, like, Rummy or something more fun? I suppose Go Fish is probably fun, too. I remember I liked it when I was a kid. Okay, are we back to present day? Ah, so, yep.
I want to do this. I need to see him. I need to see that bastard's face.
Butter, he just killed her dad. Yep, he's done. Don't even worry about it.
Oh, God. He's dead.
Yeah, he is.
I should have stopped you.
No, you shouldn't.
How could you do this?
What do you mean, how could I do this?
That man was tied up, defenseless.
That is not a defenseless man. Maybe at this particular moment, he was a little defenseless, but Pete, you know perfectly well, that man was a killer. That man was gonna see all of us dead if he could. I can't... I know, we just gotta... I think they must have done that on purpose, showing us the happy scene with Pete to remind us he is a really good guy, so that when we get to this scene, hopefully we won't be too pissed off at him. And it's working, because my instinct is, it's got my back up. That man was defenseless. How could you do this? How could I not? I would feel wrong if I didn't. This is a man who's going out of his way to hurt people, to kill people. He's dangerous, and he's sick. He's a threat to every other survivor. But I can't be too mad at Pete, because we did just see that Pete's just a tender-hearted guy. He trusts too much, but it's important. He's not the kind of guy you want in charge, because he overestimates people, and he'll make mistakes giving people the benefit of the doubt that will get you killed. But there's value to his kind of thinking. There's value to the idea that there can be hope in the world and that you can give people a second chance. So... Well, just tell him. I'm not sorry.
He got what he deserved.
I knew I shouldn't have left you alone with him.
You wouldn't. You couldn't have stopped me. If you had been here, I'd have done it anyhow.
I wanted this. I did, but seeing him now?
No, this is good.
I wish I'd been the one to do it.
There you go.
Sam.
It was my dad. My family. I should have killed Randall myself.
You're right. If I could do it over again, I'd let you hold the wrench.
Too late for that now. Sam,
calm down. Let her. If this is what she needs.
My dad isn't even in the fucking ground yet, and you want me to calm down? I didn't mean... He ruined everything.
He did. Well, I mean, no. Gotta pause here, Sam. You ruined everything because you kept stealing from his people and got yourself on his radar. I mean, seriously, Norma let you go the once. You should have stayed away. But, I mean, Randall is the one who... killed her brother, killed her dad. I mean, yeah, he's the one that's bringing down... Like, where we are now, we need to go. This is no longer a safe place. Randall's only one of many. They're out looking for us. We gotta get out of here. But, yeah, he is a ruiner.
He killed... I know.
Pick
you
up,
don't know.
Michonne.
Wait. You hear that?
Answer me.
Well, she knows that we got him. She was not fooled.
Michonne? You don't want to keep me waiting.
I'm right here.
Good. You might be sitting pretty, thinking you have the upper hand.
I don't, actually.
Your luck has changed.
Michonne and Sadiq. They got the rest of the crew, too. Oak and Berto. Look, whatever this bitch asks, don't...
Sadiq!
I take that as a don't do it.
We're all in good hands here. But them staying that way is up to you. So listen closely. I'm willing to trade my brother for your friends.
Well.
But anything you do to Randall, I will do to them. Do you understand?
I understand. Guys, he's turning. How's he turning? I hit him in the head.
Look, you don't owe me anything, but please, we have to get them back.
We do, but I...
That's my deal, Michonne.
I understand.
That's what I like to hear.
Don't need to tell her that
He'll
he's dead now.
Be there by sunrise. Be ready for us.
All right, what we really need to do, team... There we go. Oh, here's your chance, Sam. You want it? He's all yours. Well, we're in a pickle. So what I think we should do is either plan an ambush or leave here and not give up on the crew completely, of course, but try and find some way back to Boat Town to try and find him and release him. Something. I mean, we have the threat of Randall out of the way. That's something. But obviously waiting here and talking to Norma face to face is going to be a dumb plan, because she's going to come up here with a big ol' force and all kinds of weapons and everything else, and what are we supposed to do against that? I have a feeling, though, from what at the end of episode 2, when it showed the next time on, I think we're probably going to try to stay here and hold our ground, which is stupid. But if that's what we're doing, I guess that's what we're doing. At this point, I do care about the boat crew, and I do want to save boat crew. But also, we've killed Randall, so we have to be really tricky with Norma. We can't just deal honestly with her at this point. She's gonna flip when she knows that Randall's dead. We're gonna give her zombie Randall? Guys. What is our plan here?
She's coming here for her brother. When she sees what we did to him.
You think you're gonna psych her out? Oh, guys.
At least he can walk, right?
All she needs to do is hear him go, wah, 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 and that's gonna be that.
Take it out on my guys.
Norma wants her brother. It's not like there's another option here.
The bag helps. A little.
She's gonna want to see his face.
Maybe we can stall her.
And then what?
We should just give up on this idea. It's not good.
Norma's not gonna leave us alone.
She's not. We gotta go. All
she
of you gotta go.
Just because we gave her brother back. Even if he was alive, we still burned all their shit.
Yeah.
So we run.
Yep.
After you trade for your friends, we haul ass to the back gate and get the hell out of here.
But she'd take the house. Let her have it.
Yeah.
Wouldn't she expect us to run?
So what? She knows where we are now. Hiding isn't an option.
Okay, it won't be that easy, but I don't want to support any plan that sounds like stay in the house, because we need to get out of the house.
So let's just go.
It might work.
We just have to be quick. The minute your guys are inside, we're out of here.
I think they should go before we get our guys.
You can listen to this.
Sam, come back here.
Sam, you can't keep the house. There's no way you can keep the house. She knows where it is. You can't ever be safe here again. Sorry.
Sam!
All right. Well, she's obviously taking him to her mom.
God damn it. Sam, stop. Maybe you're all ready to walk away, but I'm not just going to leave him like this.
Sam, you have to. We don't have time to bury someone. Don't any of you look at me, Sam, and other gal like I should.
My dad and I had to bury her here. Just the two of us. He'd want to be with her. That's all I can give
I understand, but really...
We don't have time for this. Not with Norma coming.
We don't. I'm
we
sorry,
have to
Sam.
Be ready to leave.
I'm not going.
What? Sam, you can't still be thinking
my mom is here, Paige. Everything I have of her. And Greg, if you want to leave, go ahead, but I'm not coming with you.
Gotta remind myself she's young and she's grieving, because I'm really mad at her right now, because this whole situation, this whole thing started because she decided to steal multiple times from Norma. That's what could have avoided all of this, Sam. But you didn't. You stole from her, she let you go, you learned nothing, you stole from her again, now you just have to cut your losses and run. Her dad just died, she's not in a normal frame of mind. Oh, that's jarring.
I'm sorry. But I can't go.
You have to go.
This house meant everything to my dad. It's all I have left.
I know you don't want to, but leaving might be your only option. It isn't safe here anymore.
I know, but I can't just give up.
And also, not to be a jerk, but like, how many other people have we seen throughout this series that don't get to just stay in their childhood home and try and hold on to all their memories and all their stuff? Almost everybody has to leave. They have to leave everything behind and move on and try and find a safe place. I mean, sorry, Sam, it sucks, but you don't get to be the exemption.
We can fight.
No.
We can defend this house.
No, we can't. No, we can't.
No matter what happens, thank you.
Don't make that face, Michonne, like...
my life.
Maybe we could defend
it. Sorry it took me so long to say it.
Okay. The soft, tender part of me is like, I should help her, because I get where she's coming from, and I get that she wants to bury him, but... And I feel like the game's gonna force me into a confrontation with Norma regardless. So, like, I have a suspicion that helping her or not, the only difference is gonna make is how many, like, Sam affection points I have. And I'd rather she like me, but at the same time, we're gonna play this as if I really was Michonne in this situation, and we just do not have time for this nonsense. I'm sorry, Sam, but no, burying a person is a lot of work, and we can't afford to do it right now. We got other things we gotta do. So, we're stopping her.
Oh, come on.
Even though it's gonna piss her off.
Sam, stop.
Please.
It's not like one quick thing to do, Sam. It'll take a while, and we've gotta make preparations.
Maybe I can't help him, but I'm not gonna let Norma take the rest of my family from me.
Then you should get your family and run.
I've got some weapons stashed in my room. Old duffel bag. Should look familiar. You should make sure everyone's armed before Norma gets here.
Yeah.
This is stupid that we're even trying to trade him. Alternate plan, guys. We need an alternate plan. Hold it together, Michonne. Alright, what do we got in here? It doesn't look like a whole lot that I can interact with, huh? Okay, well. Oh, no going this way? James is it. Okay. I Anything in the room? What you doing there, kiddo?
I was just... wanted to know what it felt like. I wasn't gonna shoot it. Just...
Well, it's probably good to have everybody armed.
Careful. You don't want to shoot yourself.
He should probably know how to use one. When we were Leewee's hot Clem, let's teach this kid.
Empty.
Can I help? I want to do something.
Yeah.
Sure, go ahead. Those slide in there. Round side forward.
It's good for him to know this could save our life.
Just die like that. Greg and Dad.
World's cruel place.
I thought we were safe here. What am I supposed to do?
Everyone gets scared sometimes.
I'm not afraid.
Just sad.
The guy who did it killed my dad. He's gotta... I mean...
I already killed him, kiddo.
The things he said... The way he was laughing about Dad...
was really horrible.
Randall is dead, James. I killed him.
I heard you guys talking. There's more people coming.
Yep.
To the house. Sam's hurt. If she... They can't hurt her, too. You have to stop them.
We really need to stop them by just leaving.
Your sister will be with me. I'll make sure she's safe.
Possibly foolhardy to make that promise, but...
I don't know if I'm ready. You know, to have one.
I think you need one.
Hang on to this. You don't know when you might need it. Norma's on her way. Things could go wrong in a hurry.
I'll be careful.
Good. I think we should have taught him more than that. Does he know how to even shoot it or anything? But...
wish it didn't always come to this.
Now I feel her there. That she wishes it didn't always come out. Okay, yeah, I get that. But I don't feel that giving him the gun pushes it in that direction. It's already there. We're already staying here trying to make a deal with Norma, and she's going to bring a whole lot of people with guns. So at this point, we're not jumping to guns as the answer. It's a response to other people's guns. It would be foolish not to weaponize that kid at this point, because, you know, what if he's in a point where he needs the gun to save his life or whatever? Things could go really, really wrong when we try this trade-off, which is a stupid idea. So, yeah, probably better to have him equipped. I'm really hoping that the game doesn't punish me, though, for giving that gun by having him accidentally shoot himself or accidentally shoot somebody he cares about, because that'll really, really suck. Because I am concerned that we didn't really get, like, when Lee taught Clem about the gun, he had her practice aiming and everything else, and it was a much more comprehensive. This was, like, maybe 2 minutes of chatting with him, and that's it, and we gave him a gun. Don't feel great about that, but we'll see how it goes. Now, I do also feel like when we got the short talk with our friends there, they said don't, and I'm pretty sure what they were going to say is don't do whatever she wants you to do, don't trust her, don't cooperate. So, again, yeah, we need to save them, but attempting a trade-off is very foolish. She's going to figure out fast that Randall's a zombie. Ugh. It's a bad plan. I know I keep saying that, I just feel... don't like it. Don't like it. Hand out guns to Pete, Sam, and Paige. Let's do. Ooh, now we can look at things. Kids' drawings.
Alex must have drawn this one. I hope he's okay.
Alright, we can go to Sam's room. We can go to the garage. Anything else in here? Alright, we'll save the garage. since that feels like maybe the last place to go, since that's where Randall is. Sam's room has a door to outside.
Wow. She's been all over the world. Those days are long gone now.
Right behind you.
Oh, I might need to be
Sam's
faster.
Passport. This must be her mother. Sophia Fairbanks. Almost out of space in these. Sam's mom wrote this. Took Sam to see the Eiffel Tower. I don't think she cared much for it, but we found a little shop on the way back and ate about 50 macarons each. I blame the pregnancy. Sam blames our shared sweet tooth. At least Sam has some happy memories to hold on to.
Away. Why, is that a picture of Michonne's daughters?
Sam's mom. Looks like she was pretty sick.
Okay, that was weird. That was the look at option. Let's talk to.
This is a mess.
Yeah, it is.
I can't believe how fucking stupid I was. I get so focused on finding people. I wasn't putting the crew first. I didn't insist on looking. If I didn't turn us around and lead us here, none of this would have happened.
It's not your fault, Pete. You didn't know this would happen.
Oak knew. I should have fucking listened.
Mm.
You'd think after all this time, after everything we've had to do to survive, people would want to help each other.
You would think so, but...
But no. They're just guarding what's theirs and taking out whoever gets in their way. I don't know why I even bother trying to help anymore. Doesn't seem worth it. Maybe I was just fooling myself. I wanted to think there were people worth helping. And now we all have to pay the price for it.
Careful, Pete. You're starting to sound like me.
We have to get my crew back.
I know, it's really important to you.
Hopefully my boat is still in one piece. Shit. What the hell are we gonna do?
We'll work something out.
What happens after we hand him over? If she takes that bag off, are we really prepared for that?
No. Sounds like Paige wants to run. Not the worst idea?
Not the great idea.
I'm not leaving without my guys, but once we get them back... Yeah, I'm in.
I just don't feel like fighting's a good idea either. We're sure to lose some people. Running will do that as well. Take a gun, please.
Here, Pete.
Thanks.
That could be a good weapon.
Not gonna be able to look at that the same way again.
Well, don't leave it there. Take it. Anything you can use.
James and Alex. Wonder how they'll get through all this. Old record player.
Oh, why not?
Look, look, see that matchless host. March along in the Lord they boast. For Pharaoh's army got drowned. Oh, Mary, don't you weep. Oh, Mary, don't you weep, don't you weep. Oh, Mary, don't you weep, for Pharaoh's army got drowned. And oh, Mary, don't you weep. Who are the people who look so grand? They must be headed for the promised land, for Pharaoh's army got drowned. And oh, Mary, don't you weep. They are so happy, just hear them sing. They must be looking for the coming king, for Pharaoh's army got drowned. And oh,
uh-oh.
Mary, don't you weep. Oh, Mary, don't you weep, don't you weep. Oh, Mary, don't you weep.
done with that, eh? Oh, that's kind of creepy. Yeah, we're certainly losing it. Let's see. Let's go upstairs. Alright, and there's the autosave. So actually, I'm gonna go ahead and wind the episode down here. Please like and subscribe if you've enjoyed this. Come back and next time we'll finish distributing our guns and see how the handoff with Norma goes.